Jy is geskakel op die Groot Ontbyt, Groot FM 90.5 en dan ook kanaal 144 op. Kyk net, saam met ons in die ateljee, Majosi, a big welcome.
Hallo, hallo, hoe gaan dit, mense?
Ons gaan lekker. Ons het nou besluit, jy is nou hier in die Pretoria in, ons gaan jou naam verander na Matswane.
Matswane?
Nie Majosi, dit is wel baie. En dan kan jy die Kaapstad toe gaan, it's gonna be my mother city.
My mother city. Okay.
That's a lucky name.
My Cape kan ook wat. I mean, yeah, that's okay, you know what I mean? I mean, people like doing that, but I'm like, it's my name. I don't like Joburg that much. You know what I mean?
How did it come about being from Durban?
It's my actual surname. It's like a surname. Yeah,
it's not a stage name.
No, not a stage name, man. My actual surname from my father, but it doesn't mean anything. But apparently, in Swahili, it means tears. Like that's what
that's
it means.
Sad.
Yeah,
that's
very
deep.
Sad.
That's whenever very I'm sad.
When I'm in the Uber and there's a Swahili speaker, he's like, oof, you should change your name. I'm like, it's my surname. I can't change my name.
So what's your name?
It's Nhlanhla, means lucky.
Nhlanhla?
Yeah.
Lucky tears.
Nisa Zinganilani.
No.
Oh, that's why you changed your name. Nhlanhla means lucky.
I know, I'm having problems with my names lately. I've got to watch out. Like, there's too many bad connotations around those names. But anyways, but my first name means lucky, so it's not too bad.
No, it's okay. They cancel out one another, so it's okay.
Lucky tears.
And then, I mean, you've been busy, but you're surprising us with new music. We're going to talk about the music a bit later. Mm. But it's a fact that people in the beginning, we thought you from overseas.
Oh,
you know, it's
Jesus,
like
nice.
The first time people see you, like, what? Is that Majosi? did you get that a lot?
Yes, yeah. I think it's just the way things people are exposed to and what people are used to. They're not used to seeing a black person from Durban doing folk music. And I was really lucky to work with really good guys who were very good at what they did. Like, I worked with Ewald van Rensburg from Monarch.
Yes.
And in the first days, and also Hugo Ludic from Adam, if you guys know them. And they're like excellent, you know, they produce really, really good music. And I just guess I had a standard to uphold, friends with Gangs of Ballet and other bands like that. And those bands I really look up to. So it was just like, cool, we're just going to do really, really good music. So,
yeah. Oh, Brad. Well, I think our time, Andrew's got a question.
I think our time is basically up.
Yeah, but keep that question.
I'll keep the question because I think we still have a lot of stuff that we actually want to ask you. So you're not really going to get rid of us.
Andrew, I'm just a girl standing in front of a man asking him to love me.
We'll ask him to write a song about that.
I'm going
to
blow it. Van Nhlanhla Nene, now Nhlanhla Majosi in the atelier.
He's just not going to let go.
I don't have as much influence as that guy, that's for sure.
Yeah, but what's the coincidence for him to be in the news? So it was myself further with Hiri Loban. 2 years, working on new music. Mm. Hendry wanted to ask you your influence.
Your influences, because usually when you speak to people, they usually have this kind of influence, whether it be in the music industry, whether it be family or whatever. What would you say are most of your or are some of your most influential people in your life?
I've got you. I think definitely my faith plays a big part in who I am and how I write and what I've funnel my music through, you know? Mm-hmm. You know, I'm Christian and like, so you'll see like a lot of my values come out and the way I try and figure life out. So whatever I'm writing about, whether it's about love, whether it's about something political, whether it's about not being in love or whatever it is, it's always funneled through that thing. And I think the people around me influence me a lot. You know, I love just watching and listening to people and, you know, just especially I've got a lot of older friends and they pass down some wisdom to me. And sometimes I don't listen. And sometimes my songs are about how stupid I was to not listen to them. And I think that's my main kind of influence, you know. And every now and then it'll be like someone like Ed Sheeran who's coming to South Africa, you know, because I connect with him, you know. It always has to be on some kind of emotional level. It's never just on an intellectual level. It's more on an emotional level where I actually feel something, where that person's influence changes my mood, if that makes sense.
And he's back in court today. Again.
Again, yeah.
But because
man.
Of a song, the second time. I don't know. But that is
more
that
than
is
the second
technical.
Time.
Was it more than a second
yeah,
time?
Yeah, man. It's becoming harder and harder now to make new songs because it's like, what are you going to do? There are only so many chords. And so we'll see how this goes. But I mean, I love the guy. I don't think he did anything wrong.
Who's going to open for him?
I'm really hoping it's going to be me.
We got to mouth someone.
I'm really, I've been trying to punt. But I know how these things work. You know, you got to go through the process. But I would really, really love it to me. If it was someone else, I wouldn't be upset. I would champion them. But if
but
big concerts are listening,
I will
like, definitely.
I'm available.
Artie,
definitely.
Artie, I'm just an artist standing in front of another artist. In front of another drummer. Asking
go,
you,
dude.
Remember your drumming days where you now.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. Except for Artie Bell. I'll call him.
Thank you, man.
And also, thanks for bringing some color to the studio.
Thanks, man. This is all girls' influence. I normally dress in black, and they were like, "Please wear color." And
especially
I was like,
a cold day like today.
Yeah,
yeah, it's cool. Yeah.
Okay, let's talk about Waiting. That's the first one you're going to perform it. You're going to perform Waiting later,
yeah.
And also, Darling PT2.
Yeah,
is that how you pronounce it?
Part two. Yeah,
I've got like PT. Darling, let's go. That's why you've got this sweat. You know, the sweat pack was going to say some PT doing like in the army. Darling PT2, come. So let's start with Waiting.
Yeah. Well, it's basically, I wrote it with my friend Brad Kleinsmith from Gangs of Ballet. And it's basically just about just like being in the pursuit of someone and waiting for them and not knowing kind of who they are or when it's going to happen, when you're going to fall in love with that person, when they're going to fall in love with you, sorry. So it's just kind of the stage I was at in my life a few years ago and even still now. Like, it's just that constant game of waiting, like, I don't know if you guys are single, but you all remember like what it's like. You don't know, you know, and there's a little bit of yearning for it as well. Mm. And yeah, that's basically what the song's about.
Mm.
Wow.
Ek moet sê, ek wil gemaak het of ek push-ups wys, maar as jy sit, is dit like dit nie reg push-ups nie. Ek moet dit maar op die tafel
doen. No, it just doesn't work.
But you explained Waiting now.
Yeah.
Okay, and then Darling Part 2. Who is this Darling?
So what happened was I wanted to make a love song like Ed Sheeran, but not be in love. So I wanted to see if I could kind of trick people to be like, flip, this is a really nice love song. I really connect
like
with it.
Like head over heels kind of.
Yes. Okay. And, but because I always believe like the reason why love songs like Ed Sheeran's do so well is because I'm like, wow, Ed Sheeran is actually really in love. I can feel in what he's saying and his voice and everything that he's in love. So I wanted it to be like, okay, cool. I wonder if I can make people feel the same way, but myself not be in love. Mm. And that was the whole premise of that song. Yeah.
We're looking forward to the song. We've got 1 minute. This is a test of Afrikaans. Are you ready?
Oh my gosh. Okay.
No, I'm going to say Afrikaans word and you must just say what you think it is.
Okay.
Maybe you're going to know all of them.
Okay. Okay. Let's go.
Spook awesome.
Spook awesome. A ghost.
It's close enough. What is it? You must say what it in English is.
Candy floss.
Candy floss. Pantoffel.
A pantoffel, slops.
Yes.
Yeah.
Lendelam.
Lendelam. A lamp?
Close. That's your boy Mouches.
That's
your Lendelam. Or my car. My car is just in a two-stand. It's Lendelam.
Okay.
Achterbox.
The back part of the bucky.
It's a good one.
Achterbox.
It's a good one.
It's a good one. Uitlaatgasse.
the outstanding.
That's good. Knormoer.
Knormoer. I have no idea.
I think it's a starter.
A starter.
And the last one, smoktassie.
Smoktassie. Smoked barbecue.
It's a vanity case.
Jeez, what is
I'm
going to
give you some
things.
Of these words and you can use them.
Thank you. I like pantoffel. That's like a pantoffel nice nickname for
like
a girl.
Pantoffel.
My clean pantoffel, come here.
Great, man, Josie. Looking forward to the song. Thanks for visiting.
Thanks so much,
all
guys. I appreciate it, man. Thank
come
you,
on, Artie.